नमस्ते टू ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ जेवीएन डॉक्टर खुशबू वर्मा फ्रॉम फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द जेनेटिक कोड एंड म्यूटेशन प्रोसेस। What is genetic code? So genetic code is a dictionary that corresponds with the sequence of nucleotides and the sequence of amino acid. And genetic code is a set of rules by which information encoded in genetic material, means DNA or RNA sequences, is translated into protein by living cells. This term was given by George Gamow. And to understand that how proteins are encoded, begin after the structure of DNA was discovered by the James Watson and Crick, and George Gamow postulated that a three-letter code must be employed to encode the 20 standard amino acids using by living cells to build proteins. The letters A, G, T and C corresponds to the nucleotide founds in the DNA. They are organized into the codon. The collection of codons is called genetic code, and for 20 amino acids there should be 20 codons. Each codon should have 3 nucleotides to impart specificity to each of the amino acids for a specific codon. For one nucleotide, there are 4 combinations. For 2 nucleotides, 16 combinations. For 3 nucleotides, 64 combinations. Here you can simply see, this is the DNA strand, and if we are zooming out for the DNA strand region, so this is ATG. This is 3 base code which encode the protein and or amino acid. This is CTA and GCE. So 3 codes are making genetic code, a single code. Here these codes, and which encodes their respective amino acids. UAA, UAG and UGA are 3 stop codons, and AUG, which encodes the methionine, is the start codon. Genetic code is a dictionary consists of genetic words called codons. Each codon consists of 3 base. There are 64 codons, 61 codons code for 20 amino acids found in the protein, and 3 codons do not code for any amino acid. There are types of codons, so sense codon and signal codons. So signal codons included start codon and stop codons. Sense codon, the codon that code for the amino acids, are called sense codon. Those codons that code for signal during protein synthesis are called signal codons. For example, AUG, UAA, UGA and UAG. There are 2 types of signal codons, terminating codon, initiating codons. UAG, UAA and UGA are the termination codon, and for the initiating codon there is AUG. What are the anticodons? So the base sequence of the tRNA which pairs with the codon of messenger RNA during the translation process is called anticodon. Here you can see, this is codon present in messenger RNA, and their complementary code, which are known as anticodon, are present in the tRNA. Difference between codon and anticodon. So codon could be present in both DNA and RNA, but anticodon is always present in the RNA and never present in the DNA. Codons are written in 5 to 3 direction, whereas anticodons are usually written to the 3 to 5 direction. Anticodon of some tRNA molecule have to pair with more than one codon. Codons are sequentially arranged in nucleic acid strand, while anticodons are discretely present in the cells with amino acids attached or not. Codon defines which anticodon should come next with an amino acid to create protein strand. Anticodon helps in bringing a particular amino acid at its proper position during translation process. What are the characteristics of the genetic code? So first, like triplet code, comma less, non-overlapping codes in the coding dictionary, degenerate code, universality of the code, and non-ambiguous code, chain initiation code, chain termination codons. Genetic code is basically triplet, and there are 64 codons. And if you talk about the universality, so genetic code is universal. AUG is the codon for the methionine in the mitochondria. The same codon, AUG, codes for the isoleucine in cytoplasm. With some exceptions noted, the genetic code is universal. Non-ambiguous. The genetic code is non-ambiguous. Thus, one codon cannot specify more than one amino acid. We talk about the non-overlapping. So one base cannot participate in formation of more than one codon. This means that code is non-overlapping. If we talk about the continuous translation, so the gene is transcribed and translated continuously from a fixed starting point is to fixed stop point. Punctuations are not present between the codons. The code has the polarity. So the code has a defined direction for reading the message, which is referred as polarity, and reading of messages from left to right and right to left will specify for different amino acids. For example, UUG stand for leucine. From right to left, it is GUU, which stands for the valine. If we talk about the degeneracy of the genetic code, so amino acid can be coded for by more than one codon. This is called degeneracy of genetic code. Means like serine can be coded by the UCU, UCC, UCA and UCG. It means it can be coded by the more than one codons. So that's why we can call it this phenomenon as a degeneracy of genetic code. Now come to the Vogel hypothesis. So Crick postulated the Vogel hypothesis to account for the degeneracy of genetic code. According to this hypothesis, first two bases of a codon pairing according to a normal base pairing rules with the last two bases of anticodon. Base pairing at the third position of a codon is Vogel. Means it can be changes. Vogel hypothesis explains degeneracy. So Vogel hypothesis explains the degeneracy of the genetic code, means existence of the multiple codons for a single amino acids. Although there are 61 codons for amino acids, the number of tRNA is far less, which is due to wobbling. Biological significance of degeneracy of the genetic code. So if the code were not degenerate, 20 codons would designated amino acids and 44 would lead to chain termination. The probability of mutating to chain termination would therefore be much higher with a non-degenerate code. Here is a flow of genetic information. So DNA will transcribe RNA by the process of transcription, and then RNA translate the protein by using translation process. What are the clinic significance? So mutation can be well explained using the genetic code. There are various types of the mutation, but here we will discuss about first of all in the two types. So first is point mutation, which includes a silent, missense and nonsense, and second one is the frame shift mutations. Now we will discuss in the detail. So silent mutations, in the silent mutations, single nucleotide change means A to G and same amino acid is incorporated and mutation goes unnoticed. Here you can simply see, here is GAA, but here A is replaced by the G. So GAA or GAG both encodes the same amino acid. That's why this kind of a mutation, which is not interfering any coding for the amino acid, it is basically silent because it is not changing anything, and both codons are coding for the same amino acid. That's why it is called silent mutation. Next one is the missense mutation. Single nucleotide changed A to C, means different amino and C, different amino acid incorporated, loss of functional capacity of the protein. So this kind of a mutation is not the silent. Here you can simply see that A has been replaced by the C. This is a single nucleotide replacement. This code CAT was encoding histidine, but here now CCT is not producing the same amino acid, so that's why it is completely changed the whole protein structure, because in the previous there was all there were all same amino acids, but in this last product of protein one is different. So that kind of a mutation is the missense mutation. Next is the nonsense mutation. Single nucleotide change from C to T. Stop codon is generated in messenger RNA represented by the UAG. Premature termination of the chain may be incomplete, incompatible for the life. Here you can see this is CAG. So C will be replaced by the T. So by this, basically, it will messenger RNA. In the messenger RNA, it will be represented by the UAG. So basically, it is responsible for the stop codon, and the translation process will be terminated here. Next one is the frame shift mutation. So insertion of or removal of a base can alter the reading frame with the resultant incorporation of different amino acid. Means here is GAA, C, GCA or CGT. So basically, this is shuffling AAG, and here is CAC and GT. So now amino acids has been different. So this is the sum up of this session, and this session is powered by Digital Version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University Jaipur. If you have any query, then mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.